Ryan D at ZZP here, and 3800 guys. It's a common question we get from you, so we're here to answer your tech questions about it. All right, today we're gonna talk about a fun one, cam selection. So a question we get a lot of is, what cam do I select for my car? So I'm gonna break this down into three sections. You're gonna have naturally aspirated, supercharged, and turbo. So number one, for you naturally aspirated guys, make it pretty easy for you. You have two options. Our very mild GT1 cam. Horsepower wise on the GT1 cam, you're looking at about 20 to 25 horsepower. Again, you guys that have under 100,000 miles, you guys are unicorns. It's a pretty good idea to still do valve train mods. Like I said earlier, 90 pound valve springs at the minimum, but you can put it in with everything else stock. So, but then you have your more aggressive one for you NA guys that are trying to get every bit of power that you can, and you want the, you know, lopey idle and everything. That's your GT2 cam. The GT2 cam requires valve train upgrades, 125 pound at minimum valve springs, double roller timing chain, your extra thick front cover gasket, your machine oil pump cover, et cetera, et cetera. This is 100% required to run the GT2 cam. Also, a very, very big one that people never pay attention to is your torque converter. A 3000 to 3500 style converter is absolutely necessary to see the proper gains from a GT2 cam. The GT2 cam is obviously a more aggressive GT1 cam, and it should gain you about 30 to 35 horsepower when it's all said and done. Now, another thing you can do for you F-body guys, Firebird and Camaros, when you guys are installing this, if you have a manual trans, you'll be able to rev it out and get all the gains from this. So it is very, very important that you have all these mods make the GT2 cam work to get all the horsepower that you guys are gonna need. Extra note, the HV3 insert is a must have for you guys. The stock runners on the L26 and L36 don't really make power over around 5,600. Versus when you put the HV3 in there, it's gonna make power well past 6,000 RPM. It is a massive upgrade and probably the number one upgrade that you wanna have overall when you're installing any of these cams or just in general. Tuning obviously is required to see all the gains from it, but you guys when putting these cams are probably gonna be tuned anyway. So just keep this in mind when you're selecting your cams and what you really wanna do overall when selecting the proper setup or proper course for your builds. All right, supercharged guys, now here are your cam selections. The very first cam that we offer is called our VS cam. VS stands for Valve Train Safe. And this is actually an emissions friendly cam. If you want just something for a nice street cruiser, doesn't sound crazy, drives nice, no big cam problems, and can still pass emissions, this is the cam for you guys. It only requires 90 pound valve springs for the most part, you know, that we suggest because you'll be revving higher to get the power that you need out of the cam. But this is the one that you'll want to do if you're just looking for a very mild build, bolt-ons, very small, you know, maybe your first step up from the 1.9 rockers if you don't have those. Note in general for all these cams, 1.9 rockers cannot be used with an aftermarket cam, no matter what the cam is, because it's far too much lift. So you will end up damaging something with 1.9 rockers and any sort of aftermarket cam. However, you can use our 1.65 rockers. This is a perfect upgrade for all of you that have aftermarket cams. So make sure to get that along with the proper setup for them as well. So the next cam is gonna be the XP Hot Cam. This is actually one of our most common and most popular selling cams. So this cam unfortunately won't pass emissions, and especially if they do a sniffer test, you're not gonna pass it. Another thing about this cam is that you can't have your stock valve train with this one. You're gonna need very specific mods. For instance, at minimum comp 136 pound valve springs, modified steel retainers, double roller timing chain, extra thick front cover gasket, and your machine oil pump cover as well. At minimum, those are gonna be certain mods that you will need to run this. Also, it is highly recommended that you get a PCM tune with this because the XP cam tends to make most of its power in the higher RPM range. That's why you need most of your valve train components to make sure you can rev the car safely without valve floating or damaging anything. And so typically around the 6300 to the 6700 range is where the XP cam is really gonna shine. This cam sounds pretty aggressive, definitely not stock, not as aggressive as some of our other cams, but still you're gonna get a nice sound and a very balanced street experience from this. And so in terms of aggression, the very next cam is the NIC. 3800 guys, it's not NIC cam, it's NIC. NIC technically stands for non-intercooled. So this cam is kind of optimized for a non-intercooled car. However, you can use it on an intercooled car just fine. So there are a few things with this cam though. This cam has very low LSA, so it's idle is very choppy. So if you want the big cam sound and everything else, this is gonna be the cam for you. Also, it does require a lot of valve train mods, pretty much the exact same valve train mods as the XP cam that I just mentioned. So also, this cam obviously still won't pass emissions with this, as well as you can't have a catalytic converter with this cam. Your cat won't last with this cam. And if you have like a tailwind and you stand at a stoplight, you're gonna smell your exhaust all in your car. It's a very aggressive cam overall. You know, we prefer to tell people that, you know, if you're not intercooled, this is the cam you wanna run. But overall, you know, it's not gonna drive like a perfectly stock car anymore with this cam, versus your VS and XP cam will still drive pretty stock, you know, when you're normal driving. Just kind of keep that in mind when you're choosing your cam options. So the next and final cam for you supercharged guys are Billy Badass one. That's gonna be our XPZ cam. The main thing with this cam is that you really need to have ported heads to see the gains with this. It requires pretty much the same valve train mods as the other ones. Your push rod length may need to be different depending on what you do, as well as you may need at least 150 pound valve springs and retainers. This cam is for when you're trying to go all out, run as fast as time as possible, and give the car everything it has. This is the same cam that, for those of you who have been in the 300 game for a while, that Zoomer used in his car to run nines. Pretty much every fastest record is on an XPZ cam. So if you are looking to get the fastest drag race cam you can get, the XPZ is the way to go. But you have to have ported heads for this, preferably aluminum heads, to make this cam run exactly how you want it to. Now, turbo guys, you guys have it pretty easy too. I can never say this name right, so Matt or Steve or Turbo Tim may yell at me for that, but it's our ST cams, our Statama kits. So as of right now, we have our ST2, ST4, and ST5 turbo cams. ST2 cam, super light for a street build, pretty much the XP cam of a turbo build. And then next after that is the ST4. So the ST2 and ST4 both gonna require some valve train modifications. Both gonna need at minimum 136 pound valve springs, modified retainers, extra thick front cover gasket, machine oil pump cover, et cetera, et cetera. Just kind of like the XP cam that we talked about earlier. Now, once again, for you drag race people that are looking to run low tens, single digits, the ST5 cam at that point is for you. It's your Billy Badass cam. It's gonna be the most aggressive, have the most aggressive lope on it. That's the cam that overall you're gonna use if you're looking to take the 3800 turbo platform as far as you can go. So once again, select the proper cam for your setup. If you ever have any questions, email customerservice@zzperformance.com and we'll get your question answered as soon as possible and as accurately as possible. Have a good one, guys.